गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अ न्यू चैप्टर दैट इज द हाइड्रोकार्बन्स। देन व्हेन वी स्टार्ट द हाइड्रोकार्बन्स, देन व्हाट आर द हाइड्रोकार्बन्स? दोज आर द कंपाउंड व्हिच आर मेड बाय द कार्बन एंड हाइड्रोजन ओनली, दे आर कॉल्ड द हाइड्रोकार्बन। आपने बहुत सारे ऐसे कंपाउंड देखे हैं जिसमें सिर्फ कार्बन और हाइड्रोजन होता है। ऑल ऑफ दोज आर द कंपाउंड्स आर कॉल्ड द हाइड्रोकार्बन। ऑन द टॉप ऑफ योर एनसीईआरटी इज रिटन दैट हाइड्रोकार्बन्स आर द मोस्ट एफिशिएंट फ्यूल। तो लगभग जितने भी फ्यूल्स होते हैं सबके सब हाइड्रोकार्बन्स की कैटेगरी में आते हैं, चाहे वो आइसोब्यूटेन हो या कोई दूसरा फ्यूल हो। एलपीजी के फॉर्म में आइसोब्यूटेन यूज होता है, वो सबके सब हाइड्रोकार्बन्स हैं। सो व्हेन यू विल क्लासिफाई द हाइड्रोकार्बन्स, देन व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ द हाइड्रोकार्बन्स? द टू क्लियर कैटेगरीज ऑफ द हाइड्रोकार्बन्स आर देयर। द फर्स्ट वन इज द साइक्लिक एंड सेकंड वन इज द लीनियर कंपाउंड्स। द साइक्लिक कंपाउंड itself is divided into two parts, that is the aromatic and aliphatic. Then those of the compound which resembles in their property with the benzene ring are called the aromatic compounds, and which does not resemble, they are called the alicyclic compound, that means they are non-aromatic. Now the linear also classified into two classes, that is the saturated hydrocarbons and unsaturated hydrocarbons. The saturated hydrocarbons are generally called alkenes. The carbon-carbon single bonds are there. Saturated means the compound where the addition reaction is not possible. And second one is the unsaturated compound, the compound having double or triple bond, or the compounds in which the addition reactions can take place, they are called the unsaturated compounds. So there are two different type of the hydrocarbon, saturated and unsaturated. Unsaturated also have the two clear categories, that is the alkene, the compounds having double bond with them, and the alkynes, the compounds having triple bond with them, they are called the alkynes. So there are two clear classes of the unsaturated compound, that is the alkene and alkyne. So these are the different classes of the hydrocarbons. Now we are going to start with the first one, that is the saturated hydrocarbon alkenes. When we study any of the compound, any of the category of the compound, we study the name. What are the name of those of the compound? Isomerism, preparation, physical property and chemical property. So we are going to start with the nomenclature. In the previous chapter, that is the organic chemistry, the fundamental concept of the organic chemistry, we have discussed in detail about the nomenclature of the alkenes. So I am not repeating it again. Dubara usi cheez ko hum nahi padha rahe. When you will talk about the isomerism, to aise compounds sirf ek hi tarah ka isomerism dete hain, that is the chain isomerism. अब वो भी आप लोगों ने डिटेल में ऑलरेडी पढ़ रखा है, सो हम उसे भी रिपीट करने नहीं जा रहे हैं। सो वी आर डायरेक्टली स्टार्टिंग विद द प्रिपरेशन। देन हाउ टू प्रिपेयर द हाइड्रोकार्बन एल्केन। द फर्स्ट कंपाउंड विथ विच वी कैन प्रिपेयर द एल्केन इज द अनसैचुरेटेड हाइड्रोकार्बन। विच ऑफ द अनसैचुरेटेड हाइड्रोकार्बन? एल्केन और एल्कीन और एल्काइन, बोथ द एल्कीन एज वेल एज एल्काइन। किसी से भी आप बना सकते हैं, एल्कीन से भी बना सकते हैं और एल्काइन से भी बना सकते हैं। सो दिस इज द एल्कीन CH2 डबल बॉन्ड CH2, और इससे हमें बनाना है एल्केन, दैट इज द CH3 सिंगल बॉन्ड CH3। व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस? दिस वन इज कंटेनिंग टू हाइड्रोजन ऑन ईच ऑफ द कार्बन एंड दिस वन इज कंटेनिंग थ्री हाइड्रोजन ऑन ईच ऑफ द कार्बन। दैट मीन्स वी नीड टू एड द हाइड्रोजन, सो वी आर एडिंग। And we have already studied that the addition of hydrogen is called reduction. Hydrogen ke addition ko reduction karte hain. So this process is reduction, and for the process of reduction we need a reducing agent. And the D block elements are considered as very good reducing agent. तो हम पैलेडियम लगा के इसे रिड्यूस कर दिए, ये बन गया CH3 सिंगल बॉन्ड CH3। सेम वी कैन डू इन द केस ऑफ द एल्काइन ट्रिपल बॉन्ड CH। अगेन वी आर गोइंग टू रिड्यूस with hydrogen and a strong reducing agent, I have taken zinc. इसके साथ reduce होके ये भी बनाएगा CH3 and single bond CH. I think it's clear to all of you. The next compound with which we are going to prepare the alkene, that is the halo alkenes. By reducing the halo alkene, we can prepare the alkene. That means if you are treating this compound CH3, CH2, Cl with hydrogen in presence of a reducing agent, you will find the hydrogen will be displaced with hydrogen and will form HCl. So hydrogen displaces the halogen and form alkane. This is the simple way to prepare the haloalkane. But another way is also there, a name reaction. जब केमिस्ट्री में रिएक्शंस की बात करते हैं, then we say that the name reactions are the most important reactions. These are the reactions are called with some name, specific name. They are called the Woods reaction. Sorry, they are called the name reaction. Here we are talking about the Woods reaction and what is the Woods reaction. When we talk about the Woods reaction, we say that Woods reaction is the reaction in which haloalkanes are treated with the sodium and dry ether to form the alkanes. So here we are taking CH3, CH2, Cl. When it is treated with itself, CH2 and CH3, in presence of sodium and dry ether, what happens? They combine with each other, the chlorine comes out in the form of the sodium chloride and compound formed is CH3, CH2, CH2 and CH3. और सिंपल ब्यूटेन. तो यहां पे ये आपका क्लोरोएथेन आपस में कंबाइन करके सिंपल ब्यूटेन का फॉर्मेशन करता है. दिस इज द वुड्स रिएक्शन. हम एक और एग्जांपल देखते हैं. इट इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रिएक्शन एक्चुअली. ओके, यू कैन मार्क इट. सी हियर, दिस इज द कंपाउंड 2-chloropropane. 2 मोल्स ऑफ 2-chloropropane वी हैव टेकन एंड व्हाट विल बी द प्रोडक्ट formed by the Woods reaction. We are just trying to write the compound in the way it becomes easier to combine both the compounds. तो यहाँ पे ये है, कहाँ से दोनों combine होंगे? जहाँ पे halogens लगे हुए हैं. So this is the compound CH3, CH and CH. इन positions पे halogen लगे हुए थे. Position number 2 पे, you can see 1, 2. तो position number 1, 2 पे, 1, 2 पे लगे हुए हैं. और यही सी आपस में जुड़ जाएंगे. और जो क्लोरीन होगा वो सोडियम के साथ कंबाइन होकर निकल जाएगा. देन व्हाट इज द कंपाउंड? दिस इज द 3-2-3 डाइमिथाइल ब्यूटेन. दिस इज द सिंपलेस्ट वे ऑफ प्रिपरेशन ऑफ द एल्केन्स विद द हेल्प ऑफ द हैलोएल्केन्स. बट एक चीज यहाँ पे ध्यान देने वाली है, आप यहाँ पे सिर्फ हैलोएल्केन ले सकते हैं, हैलोएल्केन्स लेना पॉसिबल नहीं है. क्योंकि अगर आप हैलोएल्केन की जगह पे हैलोएलिन लेते हैं तो जो रिएक्शन होगा वो वुड्स रिएक्शन नहीं बोला जाएगा, उस रिएक्शन को फिटिंग रिएक्शन लेंगे बोलेंगे. अगर कोई ऐसी कंडीशन बनती है जहां पर एक हैलोएलिन एक हैलोएल्केन के साथ रिएक्ट करता है, देन द रिएक्शन विल बी कॉल्ड वुड्स फिटिंग रिएक्शन. सो दैट इज अ वुड्स फिटिंग रिएक्शन. सो हमें सिलेबस में हमारे वुड्स फिटिंग और फिटिंग रिएक्शन नहीं है. नाउ व्हाट आर द लिमिटेशंस ऑफ द रिएक्शन, इफ देयर इज एनी लिमिटेशन और नॉट? श्योरली वुड्स रिएक्शन हैव सम लिमिटेशंस. Woods reaction can be used only for the formation of those of the compound, those of the alkanes which have the even number of carbons. The species having odd number of carbons cannot be prepared by this process. आपने देखा हो क्या रहा है? Actually दो compound का आपस में combination हो जा रहा है. एक एक carbon का compound होगा तो दो carbon का बन जाएगा, दो दो carbon का होगा तो चार carbon का, तीन तीन का होगा तो छह carbon का. Then how the odd carbon system will be prepared? But you can say if you are using first one a 2-carbon system, the next one a 3-carbon system, then the product will be a 5-carbon system. लेकिन actually किसी भी chemical reaction में सिर्फ एक molecule लेके reaction नहीं करते, वहाँ पे millions of molecule होते हैं, या million भी बहुत छोटा number है, उससे भी बहुत ज़्यादा molecule होते हैं. और जब ऐसा होता है तो जब आप ethane और propane, chloromethane और chloropropane की reaction कराएंगे, then what are the chances? चांसेस हैं कि क्लोरोएथेन क्लोरोएथेन के साथ रिएक्ट करेगा, क्लोरोप्रोपेन क्लोरोप्रोपेन के साथ रिएक्ट करेगा, और क्लोरोएथेन क्लोरोप्रोपेन के साथ रिएक्ट करेगा. तो जब एथेन प्रोपेन के साथ रिएक्ट करेगा, देन दैट विल बी द ऑड कार्बन सिस्टम पेंटेन. एथेन एथेन से रिएक्ट करेगा तो ब्यूटेन, प्रोपेन प्रोपेन से रिएक्ट करेगा तो हेक्सेन. दैट मीन अलोंग विद द मेजर प्रोडक्ट सम ऑफ द बाय प्रोडक्ट्स आर आल्सो फाउंड. तो क्या प्रॉब्लम है? सारे रिएक्शंस में तो बाय प्रोडक्ट बनता है. कोई ऐसा रिएक्शन है जिसमें बाय प्रोडक्ट नहीं बनता? बहुत रेयर रिएक्शन, बहुत कम रिएक्शन है, तो बाय प्रोडक्ट बनना कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है. लेकिन प्रॉब्लम ये है कि व्हाट आर द बाय प्रोडक्ट्स आर फाउंड ड्यूरिंग द प्रोसेस, they have almost identical boiling and melting point. And if they have identical boiling and melting point, that means it's difficult to separate them from each other. So during formation of odd carbon system with the help of the Woods reaction, the byproducts are formed having almost identical boiling and melting point, and it's difficult to separate them. क्योंकि हमने लोअर क्लास में पढ़ा है, इन द फ्रैक्शनल डिस्टिलेशन एट लीस्ट 25 डिग्री सेल्सियस वेरिएशन इज मस्ट. अगर इतना वेरिएशन नहीं होता है, यानी कि आपका कंपाउंड सेपरेट नहीं किया जा सकता इस प्रोसेस से, एंड दैट इज द प्रॉब्लम. नाउ वी आर सीइंग हाउ टू प्रिपेयर द एल्केन्स विद द हेल्प ऑफ द कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड, एंड द फर्स्ट रिएक्शन इज द डीकार्बोक्सिलेशन, अगेन फर्मियम रिएक्शन, again an important reaction. In the process of decarboxylation, we are taking the decarboxylation with the help of the sodium hydroxide. So this is the compound CH3CH2COOH, that is the propanoic acid. When it is treated with the sodium hydroxide, it forms a sodium salt. A simple reaction, neutralization reaction, salt and water is formed. मैंने water नहीं लिखा है, सिर्फ salt लिखा है. Water भी लिख देते हैं. Then this compound is formed, that is called the sodium propanoate. अब अगर हम इस sodium propanoate को, यानी CH3CH2COONA को हम treat करते हैं फिर से NaOH के साथ, not under general circumstance, in presence of calcium oxide and heat. Calcium oxide is a medium which is providing the higher temperature. Then what happens? The decarboxylation takes place. And in the process of decarboxylation, Na2CO3, this compound breaks and combine with each other. और इस तरह से sodium carbonate का formation होता है, और ये बचा हुआ hydrogen इस alkene के साथ आके लग जाता है, forming CH3 and CH3. This is the only reaction in class 11th in which the number of carbon in the product one becomes one less than the reactant. तो ये इकलौता ऐसा reaction है जिसमें product से reactant में एक carbon कम हो जाता है. The reaction is called the decarboxylation reaction, and it is one of the important most reaction. Carboxylic acid treated with sodium hydroxide giving sodium propanoate, again reacting with the excess of sodium hydroxide gives alkane and sodium carbonate. The reaction is called the decarboxylation. There are some other reactions are also there which can be used for the preparation of the alkenes, but we have taken only the important one. Now the physical properties. What are the physical properties? When you will talk about the physical property, then first of all we will talk about the color. Kya alkenes colored hote hain? Aapke gas mein, ghar mein gas cylinder hai, usse nikalne wali gas kya colored hoti hai? Isobutane and alkene. Uske alawa agar ग्रासेज डिकम्पोज होती हैं तो उससे निकलने वाली गैस मार्स गैस मेथेन होती है, उनमें भी कोई कलर नहीं होता. सो द एल्केन्स आर द कलरलेस सब्सटेंसेज. व्हाई दे आर कलरलेस? बिकॉज व्हेन यू विल सी द एलिमेंट्स विच आर फॉर्मिंग द हाइड्रोकार्बन, दे आर कार्बन एंड हाइड्रोजन. इन द केस ऑफ कार्बन देयर इज नो डी सब्सटेंस वेयर द एक्साइटेशन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन मे टेक प्लेस, एंड इन द केस ऑफ हाइड्रोजन देयर इज नो पी सब्सटेंस. Again, the excitation of electron is not possible. That means the excitation of electron in these of the compounds are not possible. And in absence of excitation, the system is not capable to show the color. So due to the absence of d subshell in carbon and absence of p subshell in hydrogen, the electron excitation in these of the elements are not taking place, which is not capable to represent the color. The second one is smell. They have the sweet smell. The chemistry is not 100% capable to explain about the smell, that why the smell is there. So we are not discussing about the smell. The next one, that is the boiling and melting point. Surely the boiling and melting point of these of the compound is low, because carbon and hydrogen is not generating any of the dipole moment. And if the system is not generating any dipole moment, it means the system have weak intermolecular attraction force in the form of van der Waals force. So they have the low boiling and melting point. And last one, solubility. What are the substances which are soluble with water? Surely those are substances which are polar. And hydrocarbons are not considered as a polar system. Even though the gaseous substances are partially soluble in water, but liquids and solids are not soluble in water in the case of the hydrocarbon alkene. So alkenes are insoluble with water in the case of liquid and solid condition, but in the case of the gaseous system, they are partially soluble. Now, the chemical properties. What type of chemical property the compound will give? The compound is saturated. And the saturated compounds are not known for their addition reaction. So there is no any addition reaction is possible in this case. The next one, the substitution reaction. Surely the substitution reaction takes place. And the first reaction is the halogenation, free radical halogenation of the alkene. In your book it is given, which is not in your syllabus. Agar aap syllabus dekhenge to likha hua hai, free radical halogenation is not in your syllabus. Pyrolytic fission is not there. Only the topic what you have to study, that is the oxidation, combustion and aromatization. Aromatization hum tab padhenge jab benzene ring mein padhunga. Oxidation aur combustion aap logon ne already padha hai, so I am not going to teach it again. Now we are going to see the conformation, and we are going to see the conformation for the alkene, that is the representation of the alkene molecules. Then what is the way to represent the alkene molecules? When we say that how to say the show the configuration, so there are two different ways to show the molecules. The first condition, if you are considering this pen as a carbon-carbon bond in between these two carbons. मैं अपने हाथ को दो कार्बन मान ले रहा हूँ, ये फिंगर्स जो है हाइड्रोजन को दिखा रहे हैं, क्योंकि मेरी दो ही उंगलियां बाहर निकल सकती हैं, मैं तीसरा हाइड्रोजन नहीं दिखा रहा हूँ, क्योंकि एल्केन के केस में CH3 सिंगल बॉन्ड CH3 होता है, तो मैं वो शो करने के लिए कैपेबल नहीं हूँ हाथों से. तो आप समझ जाइए ये दो उंगलियां दो हाइड्रोजन है और एक नीचे हाथ के पास कहीं पे है. इफ यू आर शोइंग द कंपाउंड इन दिस वे, द रिप्रेजेंटिंग द कंपाउंड इन दिस वे साइड वाइज, सो व्हाट यू कैन शो द कार्बन कार्बन बॉन्ड, यू कैन शो बोथ द कार्बन, you can show hydrogens, that means everything will be represented by you. This is called the side view, this is called the Saar-Hars projection. And second one, that is the front view, in this way. And if it is in this way, that means the carbons and the hydrogens are overlapping with each other, in this way. You are capable to see the front one, you are not capable to see the back one, neither you are capable to see the carbon-carbon bond. And this type of projection is called the Newman projection. The front view projection is called the Newman projection. So we are going to start with the Saar-Hars projection, how to project the Saar-Hars. Before starting the Saar-Hars and Newman projection, you see that what is the condition for the compound. There are two different conformation for the compound. The first one is called the eclipsed and second one is called the staggered. See, if this is the condition, that means the hydrogens are just behind each other. Yani ek dusre ko agar overlap kar rahe hain, then this condition is called the eclipsed condition. Baat samajh mein? Yani ki bilkul ek dusre ke piche is tarah se lage hue hain, then that is called the eclipsed condition. But if this is the condition, that means the hydrogen is in between, iske beech mein ye wala. If the hydrogen is in between the front hydrogens, then this condition will be called the staggered condition. So there are two different conditions, the eclipsed and the staggered. And always the staggered is more stable than the eclipsed one. Why? Because in the case of staggered, the torsional strain becomes lesser. And because of the lesser torsional strain, the system becomes more stable. So we are going to draw the Saar-Hars structure of the ethene. See, this is the carbon-carbon bond. We are considering that these are the two carbons. Then this is the carbon-carbon bond. Now, this is the hydrogen. The first hydrogen, second hydrogen, and the third hydrogen. This is the three different hydrogens available. Now, we are going to draw the hydrogen on the next one. That is this carbon. So, this hydrogen is here, the same direction. This hydrogen is here, again the same direction, and this one is here, so again the same direction. That means we are just trying to show that the hydrogens are overlapping each other, and this condition will be called eclipsed condition. But if this is not the condition, that means the molecules are in between, the hydrogens are in between each other. This is the hydrogen. And this is the next carbon. The next hydrogen is in between these two, somewhere here. That means here. Next one is somewhere here and again here. This is the condition. Then this condition is called stagger. So the first one is eclipse and the next one is stagger. These are the two different structures. Okay? Then this representation of the molecule is called the Saha's projection. This is the sidewise representation of the molecule. Now we are going to see the next one, that is the Newman projection of the ethene. This is the Newman projection. I am trying to show the front carbon here. This is the front carbon, okay? And this is the position of the hydrogens on the front carbon. The first one, second one, and the next one. And as we have said that in the case of the eclipse condition, the hydrogens are just in front of each other. That means we are not able to see the hydrogen of the next carbon. लेकिन हमें ये तो show करना पड़ेगा कि hydrogen है कि methyl है कि क्या लगा हुआ है. Projection show होना चाहिए. So we will show with the help of the dotted lines. It will be better that you draw a little smaller lines. This condition is called the eclipse condition. But if there is a condition when the front carbon have hydrogens and the next carbon have hydrogen just in between the third one, then this condition is called the staggered one. आप सोच रहे होंगे कि मैंने एक बेवजह गलती से बना दिया. गलती से नहीं बनाया, ध्यान से बनाया. ये है आपका नेक्स्ट. दिस इज द अगेन फ्रंट कार्बन और नेक्स्ट कार्बन कहाँ है? कहीं यहाँ. अब ये कौन सी कंडीशन हो गई? इट इज नॉट कंप्लीटली स्टैगर्ड एंड नॉट कंप्लीटली एक्लिप्स. तो ये कंडीशन बोली जाती है स्क्यू. देन दिस इज द स्क्यू कंडीशन. देयर आर थ्री डिफरेंट कंडीशन. The eclipse is staggered skew. The staggered is the most stable due to the least torsional strain. The strain in between two carbon, that will be called the torsional strain. So due to less torsional strain or the least torsional strain, the compound is the most stable. Now the next topic, that is the alkene, which we will discuss in our next video. Till then, bye. Have a nice day.